So hello everyone, welcome back to my new video. Today I am going to teach you the conditional operator or conditional constructor in Java. So conditional constructor is a statement that allows you to check a condition and execute a certain part of code depending on whether the condition is true or false, which is given by you. So I'm going to create a new class as conditional. Now I'm going to initialize the scanner class into java.util.star. Now I'm going to create a new method, public static void main string RGS. Now I'm going to initialize that scanner class. Scanner SS is equals to new scanner system.in. Now I'm going to. So now understand, there are broadly two types of conditional constructor in Java: if else and switch case. So if else is executed like if bracket, where you can put some condition that n is greater than is equals to 18, and in these brackets you can put your code, or you want to print anything or anything that you want. And if the information given by the user matches with the condition that you have given, that block of code will be executed. Else that if the information given by the user is not applicable in the if condition, then else condition will be executed. And if there are more than one, if there are more than one condition, like if, then you should write else if. Here we can write one more condition, and if that condition follows, then code under this will be printed, else this will be printed. So else value is like a default value that will be printed at the end if nothing matches with if, else if. Now how to create in switch case? In switch case, the information is given by the user like n, and there are cases. We initialize like case. If the given information is 1, then after this semi, that after this dots, like I'll print system dot out dot println you are eligible, this will be printed if the case matches with 1. And after that we have to write break, otherwise all condition will be executed in the same output. And at the end we have to also write a default condition that system.out.println wrong choice. This will be printed if none of the choice given by the user matches with the case 1, 2, 3 and so on. So now we should understand if else with the example. Now I'm going to do a program of checking whether the age given by the user is eligible to vote or not. For that, I'll write a message system.out.println, enter your age. Now I will initialize a variable integer n is equals to ss.next. Now I'll write the condition: if n is greater than 18, that means that n is greater than 18, that means that numbers which are greater than 18, like 19, 20 and so on, if it is, then this condition will be executed. You are eligible to vote. We can all, it is not necessary to do the create or write this bracket. If there are only one condition like this, if there are more than one condition, then it is necessary to write that conditions in the if bracket. Otherwise all the condition will not be executed, only the first condition which comes under the bracket of if will be executed. Now I'm going to write an else condition: system.out.println, you are not eligible to vote. Now I will write is equals to also, because criteria for voting is 18 or greater than 18. So both the condition will be executed, like n is greater than also and n is 18, then this message will be printed. And I can also write and or this means that if any of the condition between them matches with the, if any of these condition matches with the information given by the user, then the message will be printed. So now I'm going to run this program. Now I'm going to write 13. As you all can see that I am not eligible to vote, because 13 is less than 18 and 13 is not is equals to 18. Now I'm going to rerun this program and write 18. As you all can see that I am eligible to vote. Now I'm going to rerun this program again and write 54. You all can see that I am eligible to vote. This means that this program is right. In place of writing n is equals to 18, we can also write that n is less than is equals to 18. This will help you to save your lines of code. So if you like this video, you can like the like button. And if you want more interesting videos like this, you can subscribe my channel. And if you have any problem, you can comment down below in the video. Thank you, everyone.